I was introduced to scary boys. you would be Marie.
Don't belong here.
want you to notice when I'm not around. You're so fucking special. I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. She's running out the door. She's running out. Run, 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 special. I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong.
Downhill from here.
You're under his ringer, bud.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, this next song is called Breakdown by Jack Johnson.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Quinn, the previous performer, is actually the reason I learned it. Wherever he went, looks like he ran away.
He abandoned you.
I hope he's not doing it. That was good. All right. I hope this old train breaks down, then I could walk around and see what there is to see. Time is just a melody. People in the streets walk fast as their feet can take them. I just roll through town. And though my window's got a view of the frame I'm looking through, seems to have no concern for now. So for now, I need this old train to break down. Oh, please just let me please break down. Sorry, guys. This engine screams out loud. So I don't make a sound. It's gonna sting me when I leave this town. People in the streets that I'll never meet. These tracks don't bend somehow. And I got no time that I gotta get to where I don't need to be. So I need to break on down. I can't stop now. But you can't stop nothing if you got no control of thoughts in your mind. That's when. Okay, I'm sorry. That's all she wrote for that one. Here you go, one more. This one, some of you guys might hate me for playing, but
It's the first song everyone learns on the ukulele.
Fun one. Sing along if you want.
Please. Please do. Everyone should know this song. It's called Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I have other songs too, but this one was requested, so it's gotta get played.
Performer of the night is a singer that you may all know, One Brecken. Please come on up.
Song about cheating.
Yeah, cheating.
She take the world off my shoulders. If it was ever hard to move, she turned the rain to a rainbow. If I was living in the blue, why then is she so perfect? Do I still wish that it was you? Perfect don't mean that it's working. So what can I do when you're out of sight in my mind? 'Cause sometimes I look in her eyes and that's where I find a glimpse of us. And I tried to fall for her touch, but I'm thinking of the way it was. Said I'm fine, said I moved on, but I'm only here passing time with her eyes, hoping I'll find a glimpse of us.
I need help from my friends for this next part, so please come on up, Angelo. And Dan, too, if you know the bass. If you don't know the bass, Angelo, please.
What a disappointment.
This one will hopefully be better. I know this one more. Also, I practice.
Oh, yeah, still good pitch, bud.
Thank you, thank you. A little voice crack there, but you know.
Love chocolate, so draw a good heart, and this is what you get. Now, you will have a time limit, of course. We can't have you going on forever. You have 5 minutes to draw your heart, but there's a catch. No red, no pink. We have coloring utensils here, too. Can't use a classic colors. It's a damn shame. But if you want to come up here, we'll give you all the tools you need.
I'm in.
Yeah, I see utensils, but I don't see a paper.
Yeah, you're on. Yeah.
I got paper.
Chocolate. Chocolate.
arms over that thing.
Yes, let's go.
No. I can't start. I can't start yet.
Like I'm going to do my best to draw it.
I'll tell you guys when you start. Get your utensils now if you want to compete for the grand prize of Coco.
Yeah, chocolate, baby.
You have a
chocolate rain.
Yeah,
that's the song. Set time on your phone.
Yeah, my phone.
What were the colors when I left?
I'm sorry, I saw it in your face.
Alright, hold on though. Does a burgundy count as red? It's not red, it's maroon. How come? What do you got against burgundy? Fine, okay, I'll take it. Good answer.
Did we do it? Yes. Sorry,
how much anatomical experience do you have here?
Don't forget about this.
Yeah, that's very
hey, Dan, I need your help. Along with setting a timer, I need a photo.
You need a what?
Photo that I want to draw. I need a photo of bleeding hearts.
I can't, I don't
and
know.
And just a reminder, we do have
I almost have the timer set up. I don't know what to do.
Be better. I want more music. 5 minutes. So don't start yet. We are about to start soon. Sorry.
Don't start yet.
You are not clear about this?
No, I'm terrible at being
clear. We're not all on board.
All right, so.
Are you ready to timer?
I have the timer. All right.
You ready?
I have the timer.
You have
the
timer?
I have the timer.
Get ready. 1, 2, 3, begin!
Jason, are you drawing an astronaut from Cry's Ark? I'm also trying. That's
Except for
and pencils. Please write your name down on one of the pieces of paper and put it in front of your favorite piece.
Oh, what?
What?
You're voting for who wins.
Yes, I'm gonna win.
Raise your hand if you have not yet voted or do not want, or anyone who wants to vote has. Go vote! Get to the polls! That's what I scream at you every 4 years.
Vote for mine!
Ladies and gentlemen, please wait while I have a 5 minute intermission. Thank you.
Thank you. somebody had to put directly on it, so you know it's quality.
Great.
I'm an addict, not a joke. I swear all night I'll do it.
Good friend, Lil Dummy. He couldn't make it today, but he, from what I know, he's a great rapper, but he just couldn't make it because of other issues. No, I'm just saying he just couldn't make it. But so this one is dedicated to Lil Dummy, and
he's local.
Local.
And
he's
you can
local.
See him at the next open mic.
He'll be here at the next open mic.
Yeah, Lil Dummy.
When's the date on that? Huh? When's the date on that? Bi-weekly. Here, I'll come to you with a little thing. I'll come to you later.
And a little other thing is I'm going to tell this little story. Some of you may already know it. Some of you may not. But so I am from both Mexico and Scotland, and everyone knows that there's a difference between Scottish people and English people, but there isn't much of a difference. There's just one difference. One of them talks like a drunken sailor, and that's the Scottish people. And tonight, I'm here to sing for them. It's the Scottish man. Alright. Alright. Here we go. What would you do with a drunken sailor?
What would you do with a drunken sailor? What would you do with a drunken sailor early in the morning? Play, hey, up she rises. Play, hey, up she rises. Play, hey, up she rises early in the morning.
Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor
early in the morning.
Hey, hey, up she rises, way, hey, hey, up she rises, way, hey, hey, up she rises early in the morning. Put him in the line, boat, till he's sober, put him in the line, boat, till he's sober, put him in the line, boat, till he's sober, early in the morning. Stick him in the scuppers with a hose pipe on him. Early in the morning.
Hey, hey, up she rises. Hey, hey, up she rises. Hey, hey, up she rises. Early in the morning.
Put him in the bed with the captain's daughter.
Put him in the bed with the captain's daughter. Put him in the bed with the captain's daughter. Early in the morning. Hey, hey, up she rises. Hey, hey.
tree rises way, hey, up tree rises way, hey, up tree rises early in the morning. And that was Frank and Taylor. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Let's turn in performer ready and you can hear some more tunes.
Damn. Because she was trying to draw you certain thing on the table.
I want some.
Thank you.
Some beautiful vocals, some beautiful playing. Is there anything better? I don't quite think so. I will check the crowd real quick. A short intermission.
Boo.
Boo.
Boo. It's checking us for.
Bird. This one's for when you're feeling sad, but still awesome.
Woo! Woo! Depression.
Woo! That's what I'm saying, exactly.
Thank you very much. I gotta set up the stage. We got one more musical performance, and then we open the stage up to the poets. And then after that, anyone who's feeling funny can tell a joke up here. All right? Well, let me get it set up for you.
This is the comedy bit. We're in the comedy bit right now. Sure, if this crowd can
remember
the game, let's question for you. I also want to hear
Testing, 1, 2, 3.
There's a corner all over.
Yeah, it's a rat's nest of wires over here. We haven't taken a look yet.
And I just cuss it out and pull on a bit.
Yeah, it comes apart.
Rats don't nest with wires.
We're practically an IT guy already.
Rats don't nest with wires.
We can't have people stepping on this. Yeah. The mic isn't there, it's expensive.
Don't tell them that.
All right, we have one last song for the night for you guys, and then we lit on the poets. This next song is going to be Baby, You're a Haunted House by Gerard Way.
Gerard Way? Man, I have no idea how to say it.
One, two, three, four. Baby, you're a haunted house. You better find yourself a new superstition. They're gonna stay in love somehow. Cause baby, you're a haunted house now. Your heart will stay forever where your last remains of you. In the dark we dance together because the misery is bonding to you. Oh, baby, you're a haunted house. You better find yourself a new superstition. We're gonna stay in love somehow. Cause baby, you're a haunted house now. The nights will last forever, and the days are always making you blue. And in the dark we laugh together, because the misery is haunted to you. Oh, baby, you're a haunted house. You better find yourself a new superstition. We're gonna stay in love somehow. Cause baby, you're a haunted house now. I'll be the only one who likes the things you do. I'll be the ghost inside your head when we are through. Sometimes you scare me, but I'll come around to you. Hello, 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 hello. I'll find a way to scare you too. Cause baby, you're a haunted house. You better find yourself a new superstition. Gonna stay in love somehow. Cause baby, you're a haunted house. Baby, you're a haunted house. Baby, you're a haunted house now.
Thank
y'all very much. We will now lit on the poets.
Wait.
Oh. My goodness, gosh, my mouth, we have a final performer.
Oh, I turned it off. Do you want me to turn it on?
Encore, encore, encore. Encore. All right.
I'm sorry.
Actually be a poet this time. Please come on up.
Go Riley.
Woo! Woo! Woo!
All right, everybody. I'm Riley, as Angela just said. Been reading poetry for a couple months now. Started actually at my high school graduation. I think Abigail will remember that one. I decided to read one of my poems at graduation and got invited to read at a local performing arts venue down in Fruta. Then discovered I really like it. So I ended up running into Angela and I wound up here. I'm going to start off with that first poem that I read at graduation because it seems like a good place as any to start. It's called Falling Through Mirrors. I fell through the mirror one stormy day. It was like slipping through honey. The chill on my skin was like fresh spring rain, and it felt like I was falling through the clouds. I still long to go back, just once in my life. I remember the light trickling over the hills as I woke up to the sunrise of somewhere else, a place where the stars didn't hide from the sun. I remember the lacy white flowers that tickled my nose, and the brilliant glass blossoms that I couldn't touch. I remember climbing trees that touched the sky, and picking the planets like overripe raspberries. I like thinking back to when I found a treasure hidden in a little cave I found while sailing my ship. I looked inside with my spyglass and found a tiny chest. And then when I opened it up, it was filled with all my dreams. So I promised myself I'd come back one day. But that was all a long, long time ago. Before I forgot how to fall through mirrors. Before I forgot how to dream my dreams. I think the next one we're going to read will be. Yeah, I've got a couple of the ones that I'm proud of, so I'm just trying to see where to go next. I think I'm going to go with one titled The Clockwork Garden. I like to just write stories, kind of or poems based on kind of the vibes, or a mental image that I really like. And for this one, it was a name. So I took the title, and then I tried my best to make a poem out of it. And funnily enough, it ended up getting published in the Lit Review this year. The clockwork garden lies upon my uncle's grand estate, where ticking flowers can be heard beyond an iron gate. Weeping roses peek above the weathered red brick walls. You can watch them count seconds till their petals fall. The sunlit leaves all sway and flicker lightly in the breeze. But if you watch, they seem to move almost mechanically. My uncle took me in there several years ago and showed me what it's truly like to watch the flowers grow. The ticking tulips start to chime at exactly 5:04, and the snapdragons would snap along in just a minute more. The bluebells rang at 5:06, and the daisies too would ding. It all went off like clockwork, like a bell would ring. At 5:16, the violets sing with operatic voices, and marigolds pick up the tune by adding little noises. Dandelions puffed and swirled their sequins in the air. Chrysanthemums would chirp along like birds without a care. At 5:19, the roses sang a rapturous refrain, and poppies chimed in happily, singing about the rain. The buttercups would join in tune 6 minutes after that. So would the sunflowers, and not when a note was flapped. And finally, at 5:30, it wasn't 31, this lovely floral symphony was very nearly done. For in the clockwork garden, the flowers are alive. Every petal is a moment in which the garden thrives. This one's called Sun on the Trees. The funny thing about a lot of the ones I'm going to read tonight, I like to write poetry the day I'm going to perform it, at least when I'm going down to the cavalcade. I was exhausted today, so I didn't try and do that this time, but The Clockwork Garden, Sun on the Trees, I think there might be another one in here. I ended up writing and performing them all on the same day, so you guys are getting a little bit more polished version, but It's interesting. It's like the extreme sport of reading poetry.
That's awesome.
All right. When I was young, I'd wander down and listen to the creek. The water was my music. It taught me how to speak. The birds all chirping in the trees taught me to sing a song. They'd play a note, then wait for me, and so I played along. I learned from nature how to strum with vines that hung from trees. And while I play, I hear my chorus buzzed back by the bees. Yes, nature was my mentor. An old and sturdy man. He He watched me from the clearings and took me by the hand. His head was topped with antlers and his feet were shot by hooves. He taught me things I'd never learn of just from reading books. He taught me how to read the leaves like notes upon a page, and told me what the trees could teach me from rings that showed their age. I swear he played the banjo like no one I've heard before, and I'm sure if anyone challenged him, well, he'd wipe the floor. Why, you ask? I'll tell you now. He's old, old as the ground. He's been playing that banjo since the world came up with sound. He grew it from the branches of the first tree there ever was. And as far as I can tell, it's free from any flaws. Its polished body's worn and smooth from years of tender play. And he tunes the strings he made of vine each and every day. The bottom's rimmed by bark that's tough, but not too rough or wild. Oh, how I wished to play that thing when I was just a child. Well, now I'm old, and though it's hard to get out every day, I take a walk so I can hear what nature has to say. And though its music's hard to hear, so distant in my age, I love to watch the seasons change like the turning of a page. And sometimes while I'm sitting in my bench down by the creek, I'll look over and see old man nature, then we'll start to speak. And sometimes while we're sitting there, home feels miles away, old man nature grabs his banjo and he lets me play. The big three I had for tonight from the ones I've written for the Cavalcade. This one's called The Wild Staircase. I beheld a staircase, a strange and wondrous thing. The building there had once been built around those stairs, it seemed. The door was wrapped most oddly by a doorframe made of glass. My interest, I will freely admit, had started to amass. I could have sworn when I peered in, I'd seen a different world. The stairs were made of tree bark and inhabited by squirrels. So when I went and opened up that rusty metal door, it turned into mahogany, and I stepped on the grassy floors. And as I looked around me, my wonder was aroused. It seemed to me that in this place there's an ancient forest housed. How could this be, I wondered, so softly to myself, before I climbed, that a forest could serve as the bridge between floors 1st and 12th. Before I climbed the stairs towards my ever-distant home, I wondered just how far into this forest I could roam. I started to my left until I found a rushing creek, the water tinged with royal blue that made it hard to see. It seemed to me that somehow magic quite suffused this place, and thinking that I'd found it brought a smile to my face. Blue fireflies were twinkling between the oaky trees, while green light trickled downward between translucent leaves. I do believe I saw another moon there, way up in the sky, and six-winged birds that swooped and nested, learning how to fly. But before too long, my curiosity returned, and the mystery upon the stairs I wanted to have learned. Despite the stairwell looking like it was a normal back and forth, I saw a spiral staircase that was rising from the earth. So I stepped up on the stairway, and I began to climb, enjoying how it seemed to shift from day to night in time. I reached the first floor landing, and I took a look on through. And on the other side, I saw a field of flowers when it was due. The second floor was much the same, a portal somewhere else. This time, a snowy meadow, fresh after the melt. And on the third, I looked upon a glassy emerald sea. The fourth was yet another place I think I'd like to be. A pleasant beachfront patio with shady trees around. The fifth was on a mountain peak, so high above the ground. For number six, I saw an aspen forest, set in autumn hues, and seven was a misty moor, it's painted all in blooms. Eight was like a painting, a beautiful night sky, and nine was like a desert, glinting golden in my eye. Number 10 was certainly the strangest of them all. It was filled with clouds and rain, and I felt like I might fall. 11 was a jungle, filled with life and trees, verdant and entangled, but cool, much like a breeze. And finally, I came into the very final floor. So with a shaking, trembling hand, I opened up the door. And when I stepped upon the roof with city lights below, imagine my surprise when it was too a rolling, bright meadow. I think the next one I read will be one called Icarus. It was one I wrote when I was thinking about moving trying to decide, you know, a little bit scary going out on my own for the first time, being away from my parents, but at the same time, I kind of felt like I needed to become my own person, you know, step out, take the leap. And I was thinking about Icarus, because, well, he's the one that flew too close to the sun. Fly, Icarus, fly, on wings made of wax. Take the first step or fall to your death. You're too afraid to touch the sky, but on the ground you'll surely die. So fly, Icarus, fly. It's better to melt in the sun than give up the sky. Can you believe what you can't see beyond the horizon? Fly, Icarus, fly, on wings made of glass. Will you take the leap and risk falling on your ass? Better to shatter, dash on the rocks, than to live your life still stuck in a box. So take the leap, your stomach in knots, and fly, Icarus, fly. Please risk it all, kiss the sky. I'm begging you, please, just to fly. I gave up my wings, now I'll die. I'm stuck on the ground, but I try. So please, just try for me. Fly, Icarus, fly, on wings made of light. Please keep flying, shining so bright. It's better to burn out like a flame and never see your home again than leave behind your hopes and dreams of seeing where the stars will be, just beyond the horizon. Fly, Icarus, fly. Next one was one I ended up coming up with quite a while back on a whim. You know, I was thinking about the stereotype of the Grim Reaper and how everyone's afraid of him, and then how sometimes he's portrayed as this actually kind, caring, loving soul. So I sat down and I, you know, I just wrote this trying to see what I could do with that idea. Perhaps the Reaper wields his scythe to save the lives of those in death, so different from the Butcher's Knife, to shepherd forth my breath. Perhaps the Reaper stalks the dark to guard from monsters yet unseen, so he can protect your life's last spark to keep them from a macabre scene. Perhaps the Reaper cares for those who pass from life to death alone, so they'll not feel death's second throes, whose final death he shall bemoan. Perhaps the Reaper isn't vile to yet forgo the afterlife. Perhaps he likes to wait a while to walk with souls as their strife.